said for himself to Mar. Quoth I, gentlemen, can any of you tell me where I may find the young Romeo? Romeo, I can tell ye, but young Romeo will be older. When you have found him, then he was when you sought him. I am the youngest of that name, for fault of ours. Nurse, you say well, Mercutio. Yeah, is the worst well, very well took, I faith, wisely, wisely. Nurse, if you be he, sir, I desire some confidence with you. Benvolio, she will indite him to some supper. Mercutio, aboard, 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 so ho. Romeo, what hast thou found? Mercutio, no hair, sir, unless a hair, sir, in a lenten pie that is something stale and or ere it be spent. He sings an old hare haw is very good meat in Lent, but that is all is too much for a score. When it all ere it be spent, Romeo, will you come to your father's? Will do dinner thither. Romeo, I will follow you. Mercutio, farewell, ancient lady, farewell, lady, lady, lady. Exuant Mercutio and Benvolio. The nurse complains about Mercutio's behaviour, and then warns Romeo not to deceive Juliet and take advantage of her innocence. Nurse, I pray you, sir, what saucy merchant was this that was so full of his ropery? Romeo, a gentleman, nurse, that loves to hear himself talk and will speak more in a minute than he will stand to in a month. Nurse, and stand to anything against me. I'll take him down, and I were lustier than he is, and 20 such jacks, and if I cannot, I'll find those that shall. Curvy knave, I am none of his flirt girls, I am none of his skeins mates to Peter, and thou must stand by two, and suffer every knave to use me at his pleasure. Peter, I saw no man use you at his pleasure. If I had, my weapon should quickly have been out, I warrant you. I dare draw as soon as another man, if I see occasion in a good quarrel, and the law on my side. The nurse, now afore God, I am so vexed that every part about me quivers, referring to Mercutio. Scurvy knave to Romeo, pray you, sir, a word. And as I told you, my young lady bid me inquire you out. What she bid me say, I will keep it to myself. But first let me tell ye, if ye should lead her into a fool's paradise, as they say, it were very gross kind of behaviour, as they said. For the gentlewoman is young, and therefore if you should deal double with her, truly it were an ill thing to be offered to any gentlewoman, and very weak dealing. Romeo, nurse, commend me to thy lady and mistress, I protest unto thee. Nurse, good heart and I faith, I will tell her as much. Lord, Lord, she will be a joyful woman. Romeo, what wilt thou tell her, nurse? Thou dost not mark me. Romeo instructs the nurse to tell Juliet to meet him at Friar Lawrence's cell that afternoon, where they will be married. Meanwhile, his servant will take a rope ladder so that Romeo can climb to Juliet's room that night. Nurse, I will tell her, sir, that you do protest, which, as I take it, is a gentleman-like offer. Romeo, bid her devise some means to come to Shrift this afternoon, and there she shall at Friar Lawrence's cell be shrived. once made like a tackled stair, which to the high top gallant of my joy must be my convoy in the secret night. Farewell, be trusty, and I'll quit thy pains. Farewell, commend me to thy mistress. Nurse, now God in heaven bless thee, hark you, sir. Romeo, what sayest thou, my dear nurse? Nurse, is your man secret? Did you never hear say? Two may keep counsel, putting one away. Romeo, I warrant thee, my man's as true as a steel. Nurse, well, sir, my mistress is the sweetest lady. Lord, when 'twas a little rating thing, oh, there is a noble man in town, one Paris that would fain lay knife abroad, but she, good soul, had as lief see a toad, a very toad, as see him. I anger her sometimes and tell her that Paris is the properer man, but I'll warrant you, when I say so, she looks as pale as any cloud in the versal world. Doth not Rosemary and Romeo begin with a letter? Romeo, I nurse, what of that, both with an R? The Capulet's house. Juliet waits at home, impatient for the return for the nurse, who finally arrives. Nurse, ah, mocker, that's the dog name. R is for the no. I know it begins with some other letter. She hath the prettiest scentish of it, and you and Rosemary, that it would do you good to hear it. Romeo, commend me to thy lady. Nurse, I 1,000 times, Peter, anon. Nurse, before and apace. Scene 5. The Capulet's garden. Enter Juliet. Juliet. The clock struck 9 when I did send the nurse. In half an hour she promised to return. Perchance she cannot meet him. That's not so. Oh, she is lame. Love's herald should be thoughts, which 10 times faster glides than the sun's beams, driving back shadows over luring hills. Therefore do nimble pinion doves draw, I love, and therefore hath the wind swift Cupid wings. Now is the sun upon the highmost hill of this day's journey, and from 9 to 12 is 3 long hours. Yet she is not come. Had she affections and warm youthful blood, she would be as swift in motion as a ball. My words would bandy her to my sweet love and his to me. But old folks, many vain as they were dead, unwieldily slow, heavy and pale as lead. Enter Peter, followed by nurse. Oh God, she comes. Oh honey nurse, what news hast thou met with him? Send thy man away. The nurse frustratingly delays her report of the discussion with Romeo, complaining of headaches and back pains after her long trudge around Verona. Nurse, Peter, stare at the gate. Juliet, now good sweet nurse, O Lord, why lookest thou sad? Though news be sad, yet tell them merrily, if good thou shammest the music of sweet news by playing it to me with so sour a face. Nurse, I am aweary, give me leave a while. Why, how my bones ache, what a jaunce have I? Juliet, I would thou hadst my bones and thy news. Nay, come, I pray thee, speak good nurse, speak. Nurse, Jesu, what haste, can you not stay a while? Do you not see that I am out of breath? Juliet, how art thou out of breath when thou hast breath to say to me that thou art out of breath? The excuse that thou dost make in this delay is longer than the tale thou dost excuse. Is thy news good or bad? Answer to that, say either, and I'll stay the circumstance. Let me be satisfied, Should she be? How oddly thou repliest. Your love says, like an honest gentleman, where's your mother? Nurse, O God's lady dear, are you so hot? Marry, come up, I trow. Is this the poultice for my aching bones? Henceforth, do your messages yourself. Juliet, here's such a coil, come what says Romeo. Passion, and then Juliet arrives. Act 2, Scene 6.